Hello, my lovelies, and welcome back to my channel. So today I have episode 2 of the Declutter series. Today I will be decluttering my clothes. This was filmed during the move, so I wanted to get rid of as much junk as possible before we moved, which was really hard for me because I tend to hoard things, as you will see later on in the video. But without further ado, let's get started.
I'll probably have to do a voiceover, but my goal is to fill at least one bag, right?
No. 3 bags.
No.
I have three bags here just for you.
So I first decided to go through my pajamas. I'm just getting rid of these really, really old pajamas. I think some of them I had since like 5th grade. And I just always held on to them. But as you can see, my drawers were kind of overflowing. And so I desperately needed to get rid of those pajamas. And some of them I've never even worn before. But it was time to move on. It's time to move on. And my husband was very encouraging, maybe too encouraging. He just wanted to get rid of everything, but you know, I tried my best to hold on to as much as I could. But anyways, here we are. These are all my nightgowns, Indian nightgowns, if you can tell, if you're Indian. But anyways, so again, getting rid of all of these super old ones, but I love old like pajamas and nightgowns because they become like super soft, but my husband was not having any of it. He was just like, okay, this one, this one, this one. If it didn't look new, he was really gung-ho about throwing it away. So anyways, but we did donate it. We didn't like throw it away, but still it was very hard for me. Some of these nightgowns, again, I've had since like I was really little, but it was good. It was good to get rid of stuff that I never wore.
That one too? That's a pretty good one though.
Is it?
Yeah.
You sure? It's faded.
Just because it's faded?
Don't. It's enough.
No.
Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. That's good.
Next, I decided to go through my t-shirts. I have a whole bunch of t-shirts. I never realized just how many t-shirts I had. It's just something that I guess, like when we travel, I always get a t-shirt. And when I work out, you know, I wear t-shirts. And I have a bunch of t-shirts from my past schools. I even have t-shirts from elementary school. Like I couldn't believe how many t-shirts I had. It was time to let go of those things. I tend to hoard onto things that have like sentimental value, I guess, but I mean this was just too much. So you saw me get rid of the Mickey Mouse t-shirt right there. I would never do that, but this was just too short of a t-shirt. So yeah, it shrunk in the wash. So that's why I got rid of it, which was very hard. I mean, I literally just kept it because it had Mickey on it. This next shirt that I hold up, it looks super bad, but it was from hair dye. And it's like, it has bleach all over it. And I don't know why I kept that one, but I mean, I needed something that could take the abuse, you know, later on if I ever decide to color my hair or something, but I decided to get rid of that. I mean, I like this one. I don't even drink, and it had like a beer something on it. I don't even know where I got that from. I think it was on sale and I got it. I have a problem. I really do. This one was fairly new, but it shrunk in the wash so much to where it just like it looked so odd, so I got rid of that.
Oh, but that one's pretty. This one is from, both of those are from my trip, like when I went to the cruise with my parents.
Yeah, you get to keep one. The one that you wear. Yeah, I've never seen you wear that.
I did. I wore that with my pajamas, but those pajamas are in there too.
Oh, okay.
So as you just saw, I just got rid of two shirts from a cruise that I took with my parents like 10 years ago or something. And then these shirts, the gray one and this blue one, again, they both shrunk in the wash and were kind of like super worn out. So it was time to get rid of those. And as you can see, it opened up a lot of space, more than I expected to open up. So I thought I did pretty good. I still haven't filled a bag. My husband really wanted me to fill at least three bags, which was just crazy to me. But, you know, that's okay. We'll see. We'll see if I reach three bags by the end of this video. So just keep watching.
What the heck is this?
I love that set. Don't you dare get rid of it.
So there, I guess my husband was trying to go through one of the other drawers without me. And he saw like one of my old pajama sets or something. I don't know. But this pajama set was super comfortable. And I think it belonged to my mom. I don't know. But it was like one of my favorite pajamas. And I got very dramatic. I did not want to get rid of that one, as you could tell. And also, I don't know if you saw me wearing my Rudolph, not sweatpants, pajamas. And was it anywhere near Christmas time? No, but I wore them so that he would not throw them away. Those were like super, super long on me and he was desperate to throw those away. So I wore them to make sure he couldn't get to those. You can literally see us like grabbing at the clothes. Like he would just snatch it before I even could think. Like I was scared to like lift it out of the drawer because he was just ready to just snatch it and put it in the bag. Do you see that? Do you see the struggle? Oh my gosh. Yeah. I didn't really have a set plan going into this decluttering. I just basically got rid of anything that, you know, obviously didn't fit me or that was uncomfortable. I've noticed that as I've gotten older, there's like some materials that my skin just can't handle anymore. I don't know. I get very like irritable and my skin gets irritated with like spandexy, nylon, lycra kind of materials. So I pretty much got rid of stuff that I don't wear due to that fact. Like I like to be comfortable all the time. So I have mostly cotton now is what I've noticed. We decided to tackle this drawer next. It has like a bunch of random stuff as well as most of my sunglasses. That case that you just saw was from one of my really old phones like from years ago. I don't even know why I held on to it. It was literally breaking apart. And even those sunglasses that you see my husband snatch away, those were all broken. And I kept them because I don't know. I don't know why. So, later on you will see him put it in the trash so that I wouldn't like dig it out of the trash. You'll see.
To make sure.
Yep, that's what he did. And he was so happy, as you can see. So this drawer is full of like my tights and sweatpants and stuff, yoga pants, all that. And again, I kept all of these like really worn out. I think these were capris, but as you can see, like the inner thigh, due to chub rub, I think is what it's called, chub rub. it kind of got worn out, but I still held on to it. I don't know why, but I mean, I use most of these worn out things to work out at home because, you know, no one really looks at you when you're at home, right? So I didn't see the problem with it, but now looking back, I'm like, why did I hold on to all this? And again, I got rid of anything that was faded, anything that I don't feel comfortable in, any fabrics that irritated my skin, and also things that I thought didn't look good on me. I just went ahead and got rid of it all because there was just no use hoarding all this. And like these tights, brand new, never worn them, and they were just so uncomfortable. So I got rid of them. It was really hard because I hate getting rid of stuff that I never even gotten to wear, but I knew I would never wear them. I had them for like 2 years, and no, I think that I've had since like for four or five years at this point. Wow. So I kept onto those. I don't even know why, but anyways, we finally got rid of those. A whole bunch of sweatpants and everything from like middle school and high school, college, all of which were faded and were ripping, and I finally got the courage with the encouragement and enthusiasm from my husband, as you saw earlier. So as you can see, I have a lot of tights. Oh my goodness. Tights, leggings, whatever you call them. These were the leggings that I wear out. The top drawer was, those were the leggings that I wear to work out typically. So a lot of these, like, they were too big, and I kept onto them in case I gained weight. And there were also a lot of them that were too small, and I kept onto them in case I lost weight. That right there, it was a pencil skirt that my husband bought for me, but he bought the wrong size. It was too big, and I never got to wear it. It was just too big.
This one? Good?
Oh, I love that one.
This one? Good?
I love that one.
This one?
What is that one? Oh. Well, this is like if I need to do yard work or something outside.
Baby, you just gave me the joke of the year.
Yeah. It was like...
When is the last time you did yard work?
Yeah, I don't know who I was trying to fool with that one. I rarely ever step outside into the yard. I just, I don't know, bugs and the sun. I don't know. I guess I'm a vampire. I have no idea, but... I can't believe I held on to that thinking that I would ever do yard work, because I just, if you know me, then you know that I just don't ever step outside. Yeah, so we got rid of that one. So this drawer also contains most of my sweatpants, and other than that one other pair, I got rid of this pair as well because it never like suited me. I don't know, it just wore weirdly on my body, so I got rid of that one. And even though the material was really nice, which is why I wanted to keep it, but my husband was like, nope. And so you can see the struggle there. But anyways, I tried to keep as much of my sweatpants as possible because I love sweatpants, especially during these times. This is like all I live in, sweatpants. So yeah, let's move on to the next drawer.
Be sitting down for this.
It's so tiring that my husband had to sit down.
What is this?
That's a white skirt that you got me. Remember, it wore with the crop top.
What are all these?
Okay, this one, I don't, and it's, but it's like a heavy duty skirt, like the really heck? Heavy. It's a skirt. Remember, I danced with this for our engagement.
Oh, really?
Yeah. What? I thought that had sentimental value. No?
What is this?
I don't care about that. Oh, that's my only dress pants. Like, literally.
Yeah, I want to keep that one.
Yeah.
What about this?
What is that? Oh, that's where... I was looking everywhere for those shorts. Oh, my gosh. Wow. Okay.
Okay. So these are all shorts?
I do still have shorts. Okay.
What is this?
That's my dad's. I can't.
What is this?
That's my only denim shorts.
You have all these jeans, pants. Do you have anything that you want to get rid of in there?
No.
Let's go.
Really? You're bringing... So it was time to move on to the main closet.
But my husband was like, okay, we need a break from your clothes. So he wanted to declutter his side of the closet. So I decided to move on to my coat closet. Yes, I have more clothes in another closet. Oh my goodness. So here we go through all of my coats. And I had started to go through my coats, but I guess my husband knew me too well and didn't trust me to get rid of anything. So he popped up out of nowhere and was like, yep, get rid of that one. And I was like, ugh. So yeah, again, that one shrunk in the wash. A lot of them shrunk in the wash. I need to take better care of my clothes. But this one had like material that irritated my skin. Just so many things. There was one, like a Mickey Mouse one that I really liked, but the zipper was broken and I kept it because it had Mickey Mouse on there, but was time to get rid of it. That one right there, the original. You'll see me get rid of that. This one, Never Miss a Chance to Dance. I think I got it from the kids section and I don't know. It was glittery, so I got it. And I mean, it fit me, but the material again, that one felt like a potato sack. It was so rough. And yeah, I just never really chose to wear that. This one, again, that's the one with the broken zipper. This pink one, pink and gray, it shrunk in the wash. So I had to get rid of that. As you can see, I really like my coats and blazers. So. But I'm surprised I got rid of at least that many things because I really do love like winter items. My husband also found this shirt somewhere. I don't even know where he found that, but got rid of that. It said beauty and his said beast, but got rid of that. And those are 4 bags of my clothes. And I kind of had a little breakdown, so I decided to go smaller and just sort out my socks. As you can see here, I just laid it all out, and anything that didn't have a matching pair or was faded or had holes in it, I got rid of. And then I moved on to my tank tops and camis. Again, a lot of them had holes and were faded, and some of them had like just tears and stains and stuff like that. I got rid of them. And any white camis that were like looking dingy, got rid of those too. I also quickly went through my accessories drawer and got rid of some belts that were broken. And as you can see, there's like a leather glove, and I don't even know what was all over it, but I got rid of that. And now it was finally time to tackle the main closet, which I was absolutely dreading, but it had to be done. So this was like the first shirt. Like all of my shirts are hung according to color. I went like, you know, like the Roy G. Biv. And that was the first shirt. And I got rid of that because it also shrunk in the wash. And I had it a long time ago, I think since high school. So it was time to get rid of that. This was like a Christmas shirt that I got from Walmart. I never wore it, so I wanted to keep it because I never got a chance to wear it for Christmas.
Oh, yeah, no, you're not throwing that one away. Girl.
He was actually talking about that jersey. His favorite soccer team is Manchester United. So he finally got me a jersey, and therefore I could not get rid of it because, you know, it was too important to him. So I couldn't get rid of that. So that stayed. This I refused to sink. Shirt. I don't even know when I got this. I've worn it a few times because it's like the material is super soft, but I have no idea when or where I got this. But yeah, it didn't suit me very well. The fit, it's like very square shaped. So I got rid of that. I couldn't get rid of this Mickey shirt, so I held on to it. This shirt right there, that peach one, my husband got for me for like a long time ago. I think when we first got married or something, I don't know. But I literally kept on to it because of sentimental reasons, but he was like, it's time to move on. The only way he got me to even do this declutter was by bribing me, saying that if I could get rid of these clothes, then like the old clothes, then I will get new clothes. Ugh. So that's the only thing. Like, he kept saying this in this part of the video, but yeah, it was very hard. This was from our honeymoon. We went to Jamaica, and again, I didn't want to get rid of it because of sentimental reasons, but that was too tight and it was time to move on. This also was like one of his first gifts to me. It was very hard to get rid of these things. And I almost like stopped decluttering altogether because that's like the worst part, getting rid of sentimental items. I find it so difficult. But I gotta say, now that all that is gone, I don't even think about those items. So I'm really glad I did get rid of it. As you can see, I got rid of another shirt right there. It had Captain America. I got that for, I think, when one of the Avengers released, I think. Each time like an Avengers movie released, I would get a new shirt. So yeah, that was another memory, but I had to get rid of it because I never wore that. And again, I have another Avengers shirt. Well, this one's Captain America. The other one was also Captain America, but got rid of that one too because that was super faded. And when I wore it, I just didn't feel comfortable. I felt like it made my shoulders look really big. So just anything that I didn't feel beautiful in, I just was like, it's time to go. This shirt is from the cruise line that we went on for our honeymoon, and decided to get rid of that. I never wore it. Well, I originally decided to get rid of that, but my husband actually liked that one, so I kept it as a workout shirt. So anything that, like from my main closet, that, you know, we both still like, I will keep it and use it as workout clothes. So yes, all of these. This one was a Mickey shirt and I loved it, but it is so see-through. You can see everything, so it was time to get rid of that. These sweaters were from high school and college. They were just very uncomfortable. They still fit, they were just too uncomfortable. So got rid of those. There's that shirt again. He put it back because he really liked it, so I decided to keep it, as I stated. This one was too small even when I first got it, so I don't even know. This shirt was so old. I think I got it in middle school. Again, time to go. This one was too big on me, so I got rid of that one as well. This is one of those other sweaters. Didn't feel comfortable in it, so got rid of that one. This one I got either in middle school or high school, and I got like several sizes too big. I don't even know why. I guess growing up, like my parents would always get clothes for me that were like bigger than what I was actually wearing because they were like, oh, you'll grow into it. And so I still have that mindset. I always get clothes that are just too big for me, and I need to just get clothes that actually fit. I either have clothes that are too big or too small, so I need to work on that. I need to break away from that mentality and just start buying clothes that actually look good and fit my body and that actually feel good on. I was feeling a little bit overwhelmed, so I went and had dinner and then came back after an hour and went back through my closet, and after seeing like how much space was freed up, I kind of got a little bit more encouraged to get rid of more items that were either torn or things that just were out of style. This outfit right here, this top, I've had since I think middle school, and that was like my go-to Thanksgiving outfit every single year. So but I had to get rid of it because there were some stains that I couldn't get rid of and these little holes, so it was time to move on. I had to be a little bit more ruthless the second time around, but it really did feel so great to get rid of just stuff that didn't flatter me, that weren't in style, that were ruined from stains and holes. So yeah, I'm just showing you the items that I picked out the second time around through my closet. And I mean, again, it was really hard, but again, seeing like how much room was freed up in my closet, it just felt so nice, like a breath of fresh air. And so it just kept me going. So I finally ended up getting about 6 or 7 full trash bags of clothes that I decided to get rid of slash donate. And it felt so, so good. I highly encourage you guys to do that. If you're a hoarder like me, do it. It feels so great. I'm really glad I got to do this. But anyways, we have reached the end of the video. I hope you guys enjoyed. Please subscribe if you haven't already. Give this video a big thumbs up, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye!